Good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss modes of expressing concentration of solutions. Solution is nothing but a binary solution. I mean binary mixture or ternary. In a solution, number of ingredients may vary from the solution to solution. But remember, solution is mixture of two or more than two components, and that two homogeneous. Thus, in simple words, one can say that homogeneous mixture of two or more than two components is nothing but the solution. Now remember, what is a concentration of solution? Concentration is nothing but the amount of solute present in the known volume of solvent or solution. That is the concentration for sure. So in order to express the concentration of solution, number of different ways can be suggested. Let's see some of the methods to express the concentration one by way. So very first thing is the percentage. So remember, percentage can also be termed as parts per 100. So in simple words, it can be given as PPH. So what is percentage exactly? So percentage is nothing but the amount of solute upon amount of solution into 100. Now remember, percentage can be expressed in four different ways. So very first thing to be expressed is weight by weight basis. So weight by weight basis means it is the percent by weight, which can be given as the mass of solute in grams upon mass of solution, which should be expressed in grams, multiplied by 100. So when we use masses of solute and solution to express the percentage, then it is said to be weight by weight basis. Now second very important thing is weight by volume basis. Weight by volume basis. Now weight by volume basis is nothing but by expressing, means while expressing this, we need to use weight of solute and volume of solution. Thus, mass of solute upon volume of solution into 100. So this gives the percentage in weight by volume basis. Now third way is volume by volume basis. Volume by volume basis. Now while expressing this, we need to consider volume of solute as well as solution. So percent by volume, that is volume by volume basis, is nothing but volume of solute upon volume of solution into 100. So whatever percent comes, that is nothing but volume by volume basis. Now fourth very important thing is volume by weight basis. Volume by weight basis. Now what is volume by weight basis? Is this percent comes when we consider volume of solute and mass of solution. Thus volume of solute upon mass of solution into 100. So this gives volume by mass or volume by weight basis. In this way, one can express the concentration of solution, what we call percentage. And remember, whenever we use this term, we consider 100 parts of the solution. Thus, it is also called as parts per 100. Now, second very important thing is parts per million. That is ppm. Remember, when solution is extremely dilute, now consider the dissolution of gases in water. So if at all we are willing to calculate the concentration of that solution, then the dissolved gas is very, very less in amount. So in order to express the concentration of those type of solutions, we need to use this term, I mean parts per million. So parts per million is the amount of solute per million parts of the solution. So parts per million in simple word can be given as amount of solute upon amount of solution into 10 to the power 6. So one can say mass of solute upon mass of solution into 10 to the power 6. This gives parts per million, and remember, it is independent of temperature. Now another way to express the solution, concentration of solution, is parts per billion, PPB. Remember, parts per billion is also a way to express concentration of extremely dilute solution, and it is nothing but the amount of solute per billion parts of the solution. Thus, parts per billion is equal to the amount or mass of solute upon mass of solution into 10 to the power 9. This gives the parts per billion. Now, very simple term to express the concentration of solution is the strength of solution. So what is the strength? When we express the solution in terms of strength, then we need to consider the mass of solute in gram and volume of solution in liter. Thus, strength of solution is nothing but mass of solute in grams upon volume of solution in liters. This gives the strength. Now, very important way to express the concentration is the normality of solution. Normality is represented by capital N. So remember, normality is nothing but the number of gram equivalents of solute present in 1 liter of the solution. Thus, the normality in simple words can be given as number of gram equivalents, number of gram equivalents of solute upon volume of solution in liters. So this gives normality. Now we need to know how to calculate number of gram equivalents of solute. So remember, number of gram equivalents of solute is equal to mass of solute upon equivalent mass of solute. Thus, when we put mass divided by equivalent mass in this, then normality definition comes. So normality is equal to mass of solute upon equivalent mass of solute into volume of solution in liters. So this is the normality of the solution. When we mix two different solutions, say two acid solutions having different normalities, then how to calculate the normality of the resulting mixture? That is so interesting. Now let solution A having normality N1 and volume V1 is mixed with solution B having normality N2 and volume V2, then normality of mixture, then normality of mixture can be simply given as N1 V1 plus N2 V2 upon V1 plus V2. So this gives the normality of the resulting mixture. So instead of acids, one can calculate the same for the mixture of bases as well. Remember, normality is also one of the very important means or methods to measure or express the concentration of solution. Now, next to normality, next very important mean is the molarity. Molarity is represented by capital M. So molarity is nothing but the number of moles of solute present in the known volume of solution, and remember, volume must be expressed in liters. Thus, in simple words, one can say number of moles of solute in 1 liter of solution gives the molarity of the solution. Thus, in simple words, molarity is equal to number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. Now remember, number of moles is nothing but mass upon molar mass. So this can also be further given as mass of solute upon molar mass of solute into volume of solution in liters. This gives the molarity of the solution. Now next to molarity, molality. Molality is very important methods to express the concentration of solution, as molality is independent of temperature. So let's see what molality is. So next means is molality, which is represented by small m. So molality is the number of moles of solute upon mass of solvent in kilograms. So molality of solution is equal to number of moles of solute upon mass of solvent in kilograms. Now we know very well that number of moles is nothing but mass upon molar mass. Thus, further this can be given as mass of solute upon molar mass of solute into mass of solvent in kilograms. So this is the molality, and remember, molality is independent of temperature. So it is one of the important methods to express concentration. Now next to molality, very important, mole fraction. Mole fraction is represented by X. So mole fraction is the ratio of number of moles of ingredient whose mole fraction is to be determined to the total number of moles of all the ingredients present in the solution. That gives the mole fraction. Now let A and B are components whose moles are Na and Nb. Then the mole fraction of A, that is XA, gives number of moles of A, that is Na, upon total moles in the solution, that is Na plus Nb. This gives the mole fraction of A. Similarly, mole fraction of B, that is Xb, is the number of moles of B, that is Nb, upon total moles present in the solution, that is Na plus Nb. And remember, for binary solution, the sum of the mole fractions of ingredients in the solution is equal to 1. That is, the Xa plus Xb is 1. This is to be noted. And remember, mole fraction is one of the important methods of expressing the concentration of solution. Now, next to mole fraction, mass fraction. In mole fraction, we consider mole, and in mass fraction, we need to consider the mass of the ingredients. So, mass fraction is the ratio of the mass of the ingredient to the total masses of all ingredients in the solution. Now, let the components of solution are A and B. Now, again, consider, let WA and WB are weights of A and B respectively. And remember, these are the components present in the solution. Then, mass fraction of A is equal to mass of A upon mass of A plus mass of B. And mass fraction of B in the solution is equal to mass of B upon mass of A plus mass of B. So this is the mass fraction. Another very important thing to be expressed, means another important way to express the concentration of solution, is the demal unit, which is represented by D. Demal unit is nothing but molarity of the solution at 0 degree Celsius. When we express a concentration of solution in terms of molarity, but the operating temperature is, say, 0 degree Celsius, then that is said to be demal units. So demal unit is nothing but number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liter, but at 0 degree Celsius. This is the specialty. And if we are doing the same at non-0 degree Celsius temperature, then that is said to be molarity. But if you are doing the same at 0 degree, then that can be termed as a demal unit. And lastly, very important thing to be discussed is the formality of solution. Formality is represented by F. Remember, formality is nothing but the formula mass of the ionic solid upon volume of solution in liters. Remember, formality is a term used to express the concentration of solutions where solute is ionic solid, especially those ionic solids which are present as networks, whose ions are present as a network. For those, we do use the formality in order to express the concentration of solution. So, formality of solution is nothing but the formula unit mass upon volume of solution in liters. And remember, this unit is specially used to express the concentration of ionic solids whose ions are present as networks. Thank you very much.